We believe it's very important because just like an athletic coach, you need to be coached in the game, not just about the game, not just before and after the game. So you're in the game, and teaching is a very complex thing. So if I'm going to help you shift and develop a new habit, I need to do it in the moment. So the coach may step into the lesson for a moment, demonstrate something, and step out of the lesson, hand the reins back to the teacher so the teacher can now try that again. So it's a new idea because teachers are really kind of nervous about other people in their territory, or they're so used to going it solo. So they think, you know, what's going on here? It feels uncomfortable. But when the right relationship is developed, it is the most powerful part of the coaching.
The power of modeling when I'm in a coaching role, when I model in a classroom, it gives opportunities for teachers to see the potential in their students. We can model and demonstrate behaviors, teaching behaviors, strategies, accountable talk moves, differentiated instruction moves that help teachers say, wow, I didn't know that was possible. But modeling isn't enough. We then also have to help the teacher take on whatever strategies and skills that I was modeling so that his or her practice also improves.